May the God of hope give you fullness of peace, and may the Lord of life be always with you. In the waters of baptism, Sean died with Christ and rose with him in new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. In life, Sean cherished the gospel of Christ. May Christ now greet him with these words of eternal life. Come, blessed of my Father, who placed the book of the Gospels on his remains. In baptism, Sean received the sign of the cross. May he now share in Christ's victory over sin and death. We place the crucifix on his coffin. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. You're very welcome to our funeral mass for Sean Smyth here this morning. And it's nice that this is where Sean started out his spiritual journey. This was his spiritual home. He got all his sacraments here, and Skryne and the Smyth family are synonymous with each other. And it's only right that his final journey should take place from where his journey first began, because his mum and dad brought him here. And they said to the priest, please, Father, we'd like to have our son, Sean, become a child of God, become one of God's family. And the priest was delighted to do that. And then he received all the sacraments, which are stepping stones to eternal life. And I hope that when we have this funeral mass here this morning, that we know that where Sean has gone to is a better place than where we are living now. And the lovely thing, we are Easter people, and Easter people tells us that one day we will all meet up again, and we'll meet up, and there'll be no more pain and no more sorrow. On behalf of the people of Skryne and Rathfai, we'd like to extend our sympathies to Sean's wife, Mary, to his two sons, Brian and Niall, to his grandchildren, whom he adored, Danny, Shane and Killian, to his daughter-in-law, Susan and Serena, to his sisters, Mary, Margaret and Emily, to his brothers, Dennis, Patrick and Brian, to his brothers-in-law, sisters-in-law, nieces, nephews, relatives and friends, and dear neighbours and friends. I'd also like to welcome those who are joining us here this morning at St. Columbkill's Church and Skryne on the internet, and you're very, very welcome. I always thought Sean would have made a great card player. I remember when he'd come to Mass here, he'd sit over there in the front seat, and he'd have his arms folded, and he'd be like that, and he'd be looking at me. And when I'd be given the homily, I wasn't sure whether what I was talking was rubbish or whether he was really taking it in. And he never revealed his hand. But I think I always wanted his respect, and he'd always want him to make sure that what I said had meaning for him. We come now and we call to mind our sins to ask God's mercy and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, may forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, grant, we pray, to your servant Sean, for today we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessedness you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bonds of mortality, he may come before your faith. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. For First reading, a reading from the prophet Isaiah. Strengthen all weary hands, steady all trembling knees, and say to all faint hearts, courage, do not be afraid. Look, your God is coming. He's coming to save you. Then the eyes of the blind shall be opened, the ears of the deaf unsealed, and the lame shall leap like a deer, and the tongues of the dumb sing for joy. For water gushes in the desert, streams in the wasteland. For those the Lord has ransomed shall return. They will come to Zion shouting for joy, everlasting joy on their faces. Joy and gladness will go with them, and sorrow and lament be ended. The word of the Lord. Second reading, a reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Over all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body, and be thankful. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Whatever your task, work heartily at serving the Lord, knowing that you will receive the Lord's inheritance as your reward. The word of the Lord. And please stand to welcome the gospel. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. That is why I'm telling you, not to worry about your life and what you are to eat, nor about your body and what you are to wear. Surely life is more than food, and the body more than clothing. Look at the birds in the air, in the sky. They do not sow or reap or gather into barns, yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not worth much more than they are? Can any of you, however much you worry, add one single cubit to your span of life? And why worry about clothing? Think of the flowers growing in the fields. They never have to work or spin. Yet I assure you that not even Solomon, in all his royal robes, was clothed like one of these. Now, if that is how God clothes the wild flowers growing in the field, which are there today and thrown into the furnace tomorrow, will he not much more look after you? You have so little faith. So do not worry. Do not say what we are to eat or what we are to drink or what we are to wear. It's the Gentiles who set their hearts on all these things. Your heavenly Father knows you need them all. Set your hearts in his kingdom first and in God's saving justice, and all these other things will be given you as well. So do not worry about tomorrow. Tomorrow will take care of itself. Each day has enough trouble of its own. The Gospel of the Lord. And please be seated. Naturally, there's a lot of joy and good news in today's readings. And my God, don't we need them in this terrible pandemic. We've been reminded in the readings to be thankful and to trust and not to worry, which are wonderful and very important and powerful messages for us at this time. But you might wonder if these messages are appropriate at a funeral mass. But I suggest to you, they are. We have to remember that the cross and death are at the heart of the Christian message and story, but that the story does not end there. It ends with the resurrection, with the story of life from death. And today, we are here to celebrate and to give thanks for a life, the life of Mr. Sean Smyth, who left us and his life last Tuesday. I know there'll be a lot of sadness felt by people, shocked into realizing they will never talk, or more likely, ever listen to Sean again. I know there are many people who will feel this loss and sadness. There's no escape from the sadness for Mary, for Brian, and for Niall, for the grandchildren, Danny, Shane, and Killian, and for Sean's sisters and brothers, for Mary, Margaret, Patrick, Emily, Dennis, and Brian, who lost their sister Carmel only over a month ago, and all of you here and many more who are sad today, because they won't see or talk to Sean again. Nor should there be any escape from sadness. It is sad that Sean left us, and left us quite suddenly last Tuesday. But while we are sad, this should not prevent us from celebrating and giving thanks for the 86 years of Sean's life. And wouldn't any of us ask for 86 great years well lived? What matters most is not the number of years or the length of life, but the most important thing is what we do with our lives. And Sean did a lot in those 86 years. Sean worked hard all his life, and he began that hard work at the early age of 12, when his mother unfortunately died. I'm sure there were hard times for everybody, but particularly for a family of eight who lost their mother. And I know that Sean had to work very hard to help his father keep things going. And those who knew him would often have heard how he cut sticks, dug the garden, and was the man about the house. Helped, of course, by his sister Margaret, with whom he worked and now and again fought, Sean was a worker. He spent most of his life working in the motor industry and took a big risk of going it alone and starting his own business. That certainly takes courage. It was an up-and-down struggle. You could argue whether he was successful or not from a purely business standpoint. But if you asked all those people whose tractors and trains and transport vehicles he magically brought back to life, they would have no doubt about how successful Sean's work was. And that's the true mark of goodness. He went to the ends of the earth, or ends of the country, if not the earth, to solve a problem. And the lovely thing about Sean was, it was solving somebody's problem that gave him the greatest satisfaction. There was no shortage of miracles along the way. Sean never accepted failure and never gave up. And it's lovely to say today in his funeral mass that he loves helping people and getting them out of some mess. It is this same resolve and effort and hard work that he brought to Skryne Football Club, and it was very nice that Skryne Football Club had a guard of honour here for him, fully merited. And here there's no question about how successful Sean was in his leadership of the club as chairman. But here again, just being successful in winning championships was not enough for Sean. He thought of the future and was hugely instrumental in beginning the transformation of Father McManus Park and the wonderful facility that it is today. He crossed swords and made some enemies along the way in doing this. But in order to make an omelette, you've got to break a few eggs. But that was part of Sean's gift. He would let nothing get in his way, and when he went after something, he wanted it. And people of Skryne appreciated that is Sean, that appreciated that in Sean, and felt a huge gratitude to him and some fondness for him. And toes were stepped on, were always forgotten and forgiving in a Skryne and the community spirit. So many players and others knew how Sean really cared for them and how fond of them he really was. And we all know sincere means without wax, and Sean has sincerity in spades. The philosopher Alan Bates says that when we meet somebody, we should say, look at all the shape, look at the shape or way that God is taking, is talking and coming at me today. I suppose he was really saying that we should and can see God in everybody, and our actions that we do are Christ working through us. This should be very possible, and indeed, this was very easy in Sean's case. Everybody who knew him would have felt his goodness and generosity and his kindness. Real God-like gifts, Christian gifts. He gave himself and his time 100% to whatever endeavour he went after, like Skryne Football Club or solving some problem for someone. Like Jesus, Sean had a real sense of mission and believed that things could get better, and he worked all his life to make them so. He never settled for what is, but he went after what might be and what should be, qualities that we really need in the world today. People say it was impossible to be unhappy in Jesus' presence, and you could say it was impossible to be bored in Sean's presence. He was always full of energy and life, full of stories and full of positivities. These are also qualities that we need very much today. There were two Seans, as there were probably two of all of us. There was a Sean who would fight with Mary in public and boast about her behind her back. Brian and Niall probably don't know how proud and boastful he was of them, because how good they were to him. He hid many things, including his own feelings, pains, and goodness. He also hid the good turns he did for people and did it as if it was the only and right thing to do. He went through hell some years ago when he was unwell, but he never complained. Only afterwards did we hear the stories and the truth of all that he went through. But if he was like Jesus, it was not a mild and a meek Jesus, but a strong, clear, and determined one, who was not afraid to challenge the powers that be, whoever they might be. Sometimes it's a trait of Jesus that we don't mention often enough. Jesus had a strength to him. He wasn't a softy all the time. And this surely has to be Sean's greatest and most godlike quality, his courage. He was afraid of nobody and would take anybody on, and did. They say that the most important and deepest faith of all is the faith of courage. There's no faith without courage, and no courage without a deep, deep faith. Courage goes far deeper than mere belief, and Sean had oceans of it. Courage is grace under pressure. And oh, do we need that quality today, not only to cope with our tough world, but to have that vision and courage that Sean had to make it a better world. That gospel message for us today, not to worry, but to trust, to remember the birds in the air and the lilies of the field, and to trust, especially in these dark and strange times. To never give up hoping, like Sean did. The doctors and nurses, who were the last people to talk to him on Saturday night, told Mary and Niall how grateful and pleasant and positive he was to the very end. For all of us who touched on Sean's life, I hope and pray that we get touched by his enormous energy and courage. And on everybody's behalf, I thank God for the gift of Sean's 86 years of real life and living. May he deserve the gift of eternal life, which he so much earned. Now let us stand and offer up our prayers to our Father in heaven. Let us present our prayers to God the Father, who knows our every need. With confidence, we ask his mercy upon us. Lord, hear us. On behalf of Margaret, I'd like to read this prayer. Let us thank God for giving Sean the gift of life and pray that he will now grant him the greater gift of eternal life. Lord, hear us. On behalf of Liam, let us pray for Sean's family, his wife Mary, his sons Brian and Niall, his daughters-in-law, his grandsons, and his extended families. Lord, hear us. For Serena, we pray for Sean's family members who have died. We pray for Sean's parents, his sisters Carmel and Eileen, his nephew Gerard, and his brother-in-law, Tommy. Lord, hear us. On behalf of Killian, let us pray for those who care for the sick, especially those who cared for Sean during his last illness. Lord, hear us. On behalf of Danny, let us celebrate Sean's life and remember him with the fondest of memories. Lord, hear us. May the Lord support us all the day long till the shadows lengthen and the evening comes and the busy world is hushed, the fever of life is over and our work is done. Then in his mercy, may he grant us a safe lodging and a holy rest and peace at the mast. Amen. Lord, these are our prayers. If it be your will, we ask you to grant them to us through Christ our Lord. And please be seated. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Let us pray. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Sean, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of reconciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may by your loving gift be forgiven and wiped away. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. When this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." And let us proclaim the mystery of faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the offering of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially to most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Colum Kill, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with Francis our Pope, Thomas our Bishop, the clergy, and the entire people your Son has gained for you. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have called here before you. In your compassion and mercy, Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant, Sean, who you have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may now also be one with him in his resurrection. And from the earth he'll raise up into flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, God, as you are, we shall be like you for all ages, and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Saviour's command and formed by divine teaching, we now say, stand and say the words that Jesus gave us. Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we'll be always free from sin and safe from all distress or unnecessary worries, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
Thank you.
a light that shines in the dark. We are told that the Magi were led to Christ by the light of a bright star, but they only saw the star because they were not afraid to travel in the dark. The fact is, we cannot see the stars in the bright light of day, but only in the darkness of night. And the darker the night, the brighter they shine. Those who have to travel by night need no longer fear the darkness, because since the coming of Christ, a light has come into the world, a light that shines in the dark, a light that darkness cannot overpower. May the road rise to meet you. May the wind be always at your back. May the sun shine warm upon your face and rains fall soft upon your fields. Until we meet again, may God hold you in the palm of his hand. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant us strengthened by it, our brother Sean may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Just before the final blessing, a special thank you to Sean's brother Brian for helping capture the spirit that was Sean. And please God, he'll never be forgotten. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless us all in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of Sean. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord.
Save his soul, present him to God the most
high. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham.
Receive his soul, present him to God the most high.
Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him.
Receive his soul, present him to God the most high.
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Sean, in the hope and in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Sean in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in heaven. Merciful Lord, turn towards us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and we are with you and our brother Sean forever. In peace, let us bring our brother Sean to his place of rest here in Skryne.
May the sun. brother Sean has gone to his rest in peace, in the peace of Christ. May the Lord now welcome him to the table of God's children in heaven. With faith and hope and eternal life, let us assist him with our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord also for ourselves. May we who mourn be reunited one day with Sean. Together may we meet Christ Jesus, for he who is our life appears in glory. We read in sacred scripture, Come, you whom my Father has blessed, says the Lord, inherit the kingdom prepared for you since the foundation of the world. O God, by whose mercy the faithful depart to find rest, bless this grave and send your holy angel to watch over it. As we bury here the body of Sean, deliver his soul from every bond of sin, that he may rejoice in you and be with your saints forever. Because God has chosen to call Sean from this life to himself, we commit his body to the earth. For we are dust, and unto dust we shall return. But the Lord Jesus Christ will change our mortal bodies to be like his in glory. For he is risen the firstborn from the dead. So let us commend Sean to the Lord, that the Lord may embrace him in peace and raise his body up on the last day. Dear friends, in reverence, let us pray to God, the source of all mercies. You raise the dead to life. Give Sean eternal life. Lord, hear us. Lord, you console Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Sean and dry the tears of those who weep. Lord, hear us. Comfort us in our sorrow at the death of Sean. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Lord, hear us. We pray for all who are buried in this cemetery and Skryne. May their suffering be lessened. May their joy be increased, may the light of glory shine on them, and may they rest in peace. Lord, hear us. God of holiness and power, accept our prayers on behalf of Sean. Do not count his deeds against him, for in his heart he always desired to do your will. As his faith united him to your people on earth, so now may your mercy join him to the angels in heaven. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord. We say the first glorious mystery, resurrection for repose of his soul. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and a perpetual light shine upon him, and may he rest in peace. May his souls and the souls of all faithful depart, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
down by the